I'm Krishna Kanjani from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome to the online lecture series on kinematics and theory of machine. In this session, we will learn graphical synthesis method. Okay, so now what is synthesis? Synthesis is nothing but the simple design of new mechanism or a machine element. Okay, so now this design can be done by analytical as well as graphical method. Okay, so in this session, we will learn that how we can graphically design any mechanism. Okay, in previous session, we have designed slider crank mechanism with the help of two position synthesis. In this session, we will design the Krankens slider mechanism with the three position synthesis by relative pole method. Okay, so now let's learn first that what is this three position. Okay, so now let's consider a Krankens slider mechanism. How we can sketch this Krankens slider mechanism? So let's consider that this one is your reference position, which is a reference defining your crank center. With reference to this crank center, you can consider this AB line, which is representing your crank. Let's consider as CR. Okay, now with reference to this crank, your connecting rod will be connected to your slider. Okay, if your slider is located on the path of your crank, okay, if you consider this type of arrangement, then this is known as a simple crank and slider mechanism. Okay, but in this case, if you want to design one eccentric arrangement, so over here we can consider that your connecting rod is arranged in such a way that your slider is not passing. Okay, your slider is path of your slider is not passing from your path of your crank, or we can say center of your crank, but it is slightly eccentric. Okay, so this type of arrangement is known as a eccentric Krankens slider mechanism. Okay, so this one is known as a your connecting rod. Okay, if you consider connecting rod as CO, and this one is your slider position. Okay, so let's consider this one is your position number one. Now with reference to this position number one, if you are rotating your crank, now with input angle theta, let's consider your crank is rotated with angle theta. Okay, so this one is known as a input angle theta 1 2, that is the position angle between 1 to 2, because over here you have considered this one as your input angle theta. Okay, so now this angle is representing the angle between position 1. Let's consider this one as your position number 1. So with respect to that, this one is your position number 2, V2. Okay, so this, that's why it is known as a theta 1 2 angle. Okay, so due to this theta 1 2, now your slider is slightly moving in on its path of motion. Okay, so let's consider your slider is reaching over here, and this one is your slider second position. So this one is your S1 angle, S1 position, and this one is your S2 position. So distance between these two is known as S12. That is the displacement of slider from position number 1 to position number 2. Okay, now similar type of sketch we can plot if we consider the third position. Okay, now let's consider your crank is obtaining third position like this. So this one is your B3 point. And if you measure the angle from first position, okay, be careful over here. If you measure the length from first position, then this one is known as theta 1 3. Okay, so to obtain this theta 1 3, after obtaining this theta 1 3, your slider will move in forward direction. Okay, and will achieve the slider position number 3. Okay, if you measure this distance from 1 2 3, then this one is known as a S1 3. Okay, so now in this way we can obtain three different positions. Okay, now what will be given in your design sections? So while designing, they will give you the eccentric distance of your arrangement. Okay, so let's consider what data they will give us in initial conditions. Okay, so let's consider they have given the eccentric distance E. Then they will give the different position displacements, that is S12 and 13. That is the distance, or we can say displacement of your slider from first position and from third position. Okay, so S12 and 13 they will give. And they will give different positions of theta, that is input angle theta 1 2 and 1 3 they will give. Okay, so with the help of this data, we have to calculate the length of L1, L2, and we have to also obtain the input angle theta. Over here, if you refer the data, then they have not given the input angle theta. Okay, so over here we have to completely design the crank and slider mechanism, and we have to get the length of crank, that if you consider as L1, then length of connecting rod L2, and the input angle, crank angle, we can say that input angle, crank angle theta. Okay, so let's start this synthesis problem. Okay, one by one we will take the input data. Okay, so let's consider the first input data, that is the eccentric distance. Okay, now to represent this eccentric distance, we have to sketch two lines which is representing the reference line. Okay, so let's consider over here that the first reference line, which is defining position 1, 1', and at eccentric distance E, we have to sketch another position line 2, 2', which is defining the path, or we can say the motion of slider. Okay, so on 2, 2', we can locate the position of slider, and on 1, 1', we can locate the position of your crank. Okay, the distance between these two will not be given, so we will choose arbitrarily at any random distance. Let's consider over here. So over here I have assumed this one as your position number A, or we can say the crank center. Okay, now with reference to this crank center, that is A, now let's consider first 1, 2 position data. Okay, so your S12 data, they have given that S12, that is the motion of your slider from 1 to 2. If we consider this S12/2, okay, you have to consider S12/2. So dividing your 1-2 position, and you will get over here, let's consider this one is your distance S12/2. So with the help of this distance, you will get point E over here on your 1-1' line. Okay, now let's consider 1-2 data once again for your input length, input angle theta. Okay, so now over here let's consider theta 1-2/2 angle. Okay, so now with this theta 1-2/2 angle, to get this angle, we have to take two vertical lines, that is passing from point A and point E. Okay, the line which is passing from point A, we can term it as PA, and the line which is passing from E, we can term it as PE. Okay, so now with reference to this PA, that is vertical line, measure the angle theta 1-2/2. Okay, so draw one line at theta 1-2 angle. Okay, over here refer it properly, so it is theta 1-2/2. For example, theta 1-2, that is angle between 1-2 position is given as 50. Okay, so over here you have to consider 25 as your reference angle. Okay, so with the help of this 25 angle, you will sketch one dashed line which is intersect with this PE line and will give you the position of your first point, that is your P1-2. Okay, or we can say the pole point of 1-2 position. Okay, now after getting this 1-2 position, you will sketch the line like this. So let's consider over here that you are connecting this P12 to your slider position over here. Okay, be careful over here that you have to directly connect this position 1-2, that is pole 1-2, to your slider position. Let's consider over here that S point over. Okay, so now take this alpha as your reference angle and draw one line which is making the same angle alpha with your P1 or pole to the slider position. Okay, let's consider this one as your line Y. Okay, simply what we have done, we have just followed the same procedure step that initially required for two position synthesis. Okay, these much steps you have to also follow in the two position synthesis method. Okay, so after following these steps, we can sketch like this, that with reference to your A point, you will get the pole point P12 over here, and your with reference to this joining this pole 1-2 with your S1 over here at alpha angle, you will get this line Y over here. Okay, so now what we have used till now, we have used the eccentric distance and position 1 data, that is S12 and theta 12. Okay, now use second data, that is S Now let's use the second position, that is S13. Okay, so now consider S13 by 2, again your horizontal distance. Okay, so S13 by 2, that is measured from your first position to the third position. Let's consider this one is your S13 by 2. And this will give you point F over here. Okay, so now that is your S13 by 2. Now similarly, theta 13 by 2 we have to take. But before taking this theta 13 by 2, first we have to draw vertical line from point F, which will represent PF line. Okay, so from this vertical line, okay, now consider your theta 13 by 2, that is input position angle between 1, 2, 3. Okay, so let's consider this one is your theta 13 by 2. So with reference to this theta 13 by 2 angle, you will get the dash line which is intersecting over here, which will intersect over here and will give you the pole 13 position. Okay, so now after getting this pole 13 position, again you have to consider this input angle with the pole 13 angle and measure the same angle. Connect this pole 13 with your S1 line. Okay, so how you will get over here? So after considering this theta 13 angle, 13 by 2 angle, and your S13 by 2 distance, after getting this F point, okay, so over here you will get this pole point over here. Let's consider that in sketch we are obtaining this pole point P13 over here. Okay, so this intersection will give you pole 13. Okay, now with reference to this pole 13, if you consider this one as your angle beta, then you have to connect this pole 13 point with your S1 point and measure the same angle beta over here, and this intersection with the first Y line will give you the second Y line, and that will give you the position of your point B. Okay, so let's quickly simply revise that after following the step considering S12 and theta 12, you have to follow the same type of steps to get the pole 13 position by using S13 and theta 13. Okay, and this intersection will give you point B. Okay, now if you connect this B point with your first initial point, that is point A, then this line is representing your crank, and if you measure this angle, then it will be your theta, that is your input crank angle. Okay, so in this way we will get the length of link number 1, or we can say the crank length, that is measured with reference to your and your crank angle theta with your reference to your horizontal line. Okay, now if you will connect this B point with your slider point, then it will give you the length of your connecting rod. Okay, that is L2. Okay, now be careful over here. While taking the data of S1 and A, we have selected this point A and point S1 randomly. Okay, so if you will select your S1 point over here, then you will get the data somewhere like your B point will be at the bottom point. Okay, either you will select, let's consider with that you have selected this S1 point over here. Okay, so with reference to this S1 point, you will get the first position like this, and similarly your second position for your B point will be in such a way that you will get now your crank position, your pole point will be somewhere like this. Okay, so don't worry about any other sketch. Simply refer these steps so that you can easily sketch the three position synthesis, and with the help of this three position synthesis method you can draw the crank and slider mechanism. Okay, so with the help of this we have obtained the length 1, length 2 and input crank angle theta. Okay, so in this way we can design the crank and slider mechanism with the three position synthesis also. Okay, so now let's quickly summarize this synthesis problems. So synthesis problems can be solved by two methods, that is inversion and relative pole method. And relative pole method is also divided into two categories, that is two position synthesis and three position synthesis. Over here in this video we have used the three position synthesis method, and I have also prepared one video which is covering the two position synthesis. Okay, so with that, with the help of that video, you can learn the two position synthesis also. Okay, so thank you.